Welcome, Claudia Agosti, privacy researcher, activist. Well, maybe you're going to tell people two or three sentences about yourself, so I don't have to do it. But let's give him a very warm welcome.
Well, the only sentence that matters is this is my last night in Berlin. It's been such a pleasure to be here for some time. I cannot disclose how much because I never take my Anmeldung. Well, we can talk about the project. Facebook Tracking Exposed is the name of the project, but is also an actual URL, because Exposed is a legit top-level domain, so you cannot have a mistake. Did you hear that Facebook is messing up with the timelines? Someone in the Uban. So it's clear that this is a mainstream topic. There is expectation and understanding that something is happening. How? Because it's too easy to say, yeah, the algorithm is doing something, but what, how, why? That is what an investigative journalist can look for, what a hacker want to look for, or what every concerned citizen will be interested to know. Oh, I just used the magic to make disappear the everything. Expelliarmus. No. But I can use that arrow. I'm much more comfortable. Look, boom, you see? So I made this experiment this summer in June. For do this experiment, you need a Facebook account and an extension. When you're navigating in your Facebook profile, the extension look which post you are seeing and extract very simple information. You can see the order in which the post get displayed, when the post has been displayed, when has been published, and why you are seeing it. So this metadata can help you to understand how Facebook is in fact deciding what we're going to see, in which position, how many times, etc. And the result is just a simple visualization that show you a timeline happening the 11th of October near 11, and another timeline, the next one, 10 minutes later, that this post was in the 13th position and then went to the third place. Why? We don't know. The red one are the promoted post, the yellow are the one in which Facebook tell you some reason, like some friend makes some activity. But at least you can start to understand that not the chronological order are always followed. So for example, 33, 47, 56, 18. So why this is penalized respect of the other? No, this is at 18 in the afternoon. Why it is promoted respect of the other? Every time the Facebook algorithm ignore the chronological order, is exercising some agenda. So the project was in alpha, is still in alpha. In September, we decided to create a small team. Those are the actual users that are testing the platform. We have 62 users up to date with 150,000 posts collected, because it's quite easy to collect. Seems that this Facebook is quite addictive, so it's not hard having data. So what is the point? It's not blaming Facebook, it's not raising the pressure against them, it's just permit some tool that enable citizen, Facebook user, to understand what means be in an environment in which the algorithm decide what are you seeing, because that is the problem that is perceived. The collective behavior, now this is the only non-technical slide. The collective behavior is how the person lives in the society. And this is normally based on social policies. At the Sybase and at the Chaos Computer Club, there is one social policy that is be excellent to each other. So you know that this is the rule. You can keep in account the other. When someone is not excellent, you can say, sorry, you are not excellent. Because social policies has to be public, has to be discussed, has to be shared among person living in that space. our space is internet, and we see something new in the last 2 years. For example, Facebook and Google start to remove extremist content. And understandable, nobody wants that some crazy propaganda gets spread in order to do whatever. But who decides what is extremist and what and not? And then we know that in the past, Facebook made an experiment to manipulate your emotion. So just changing the order of what you are seeing, you are perceiving a bad image of the reality compared to a good image of the reality, and they show that they can influence the emotion of the user. After 2 years, they thought that was maybe time to do an ethical guideline, but still is an ethical guideline internal in Facebook. It's not something we know what is about or why. Ferguson, the place where Black Lives Matter movement started, at the beginning, has been reported by the researcher Zenip, that was not present in her timeline, despite it was a topic that she was following a lot. It was a part of the booths and of the hot topic of the day. She got proof that that was not appearing in the timeline, and that's make you understand that the media company called Facebook for some agenda reason was not promoting that content. Personalization algorithm are tool of social politics. That's is the reason why we want to investigate on personalization algorithm. Which are the problem? Well, the fact that we have no ability to keep them in account, we have no ability to understand what is good, what is bad, and for sure we have no power to change it. Because only the private company agenda is currently defining what those algorithms are aiming for. But recently, 4 days ago, Angela Merkel, kudos Germans, said algorithms, when they're not transparent, can lead to a distortion of our perception. That is a problem that is perceived. It's good that it's perceived. What we're going to do is a project that permits policy analysts, citizen users, to understand what is happening behind the curtain of Facebook. For this distortion of perception, the one she mentioned, is a way to describe four different phenomena. The filter bubble, that is, I'm interacting with social media, but I'm only seeing what I already know, what I like, what I'm attuned to accept. The echo chamber is when you are talking with person, but at the end of the day, those person are always person like-minded, and in the long term, this just polarize yourself, make you believe that all the world are those person, all the world share the same idea, and you keep this self-confirmation feeling in yourself. Algorithmic discrimination is when you can have access to something, but the algorithm say, no. Why? Algorithm. And technocratic scapegoat. Well, technocratic can mean many things, but for scapegoat, I mean, can be the perfect justification. Every time some content don't want to be promoted or some content want to be penalized, maybe someone has decided that, but the justification in the public will always be, sorry, the technology has made this mistake. No, did you remember, for example, the lady that take the Facebook Live video of his boyfriend that get shot? After 10 minutes, that video was disappeared. Luckily, the buzz of the internet made this video reappeared, and Facebook said, oh, sorry, it was a technical problem. So we have always this justification that in the real world can be heavily keeping accounted and criticized. In the digital world, you know, algorithm. The project, our vision to increase transparency behind the personalization algorithm. That is the goal, in order to improve the ability of the society to understand itself and to understand why these algorithms matter. How does it work, in short? Facebook users that join our project, we call them supporters. They have to install an extension in the browser. Every time they are fetching their own feed, and the application see a public post with this icon, the word. The extension extracts some metadata, take the HTML section, and send it to a server. When instead the post is only for friends or for a restricted audience, then it's not sent. Why? Because in this first month, we don't want to jeopardize every user, and if some user is expressing the interest to keep this post accessible only to the user, we want to respect this will. So the posts for friends are not kept in account for the analysis. The dataset instead is something public. The public post and the metadata derived, they get public in the database and then distributed. How to keep the supporter engaged? So how to keep the person using the application happy? Well, mostly giving them the feature that Facebook cannot give. For example, knowing how much time they stay on Facebook. It's something that is so simple to understand how you're managing your time, but Facebook don't tell to you. But we can. Or escape the filter bubble. So a logic that permits you to see what are you seeing, do an analysis of what is in the same context but you are not seeing, and give to you the possibility to see the other article that somehow are escaped from your vision. Understand your personal trend, so how you change during your time. Or which are the friends that are more often influencing you, or what they are talking about. This kind of feature that maybe at the moment are not interesting in Facebook agenda, but I guess for Facebook and citizen, it is. More happy user means more data for researcher. That's the point, because personalization algorithm has an impact in the masses. In yourself, you can tell to yourself the lie that you can escape the filter bubble. I tell myself this lie all the time. Still, you can do this effort. You can have multiple profile, look for news from a different perspective. But what matters is understand how this algorithm influence the masses. And for that, researcher has to access to our open data and do their own analysis. For example, you need to have some fresh or new user that start to behave in the same way. So you have some user with the same number of friends, same kind of likes, but maybe from different nation. Will Facebook treat them equally? You can understand. You can understand thank you to this project, if is that or not. Or for example, you can emulate an high income Luxembourg user and a low income grandpa near the border and see if they're following the same sources, if Facebook behave differently for them. Those are the elements that can be used to discriminate a user, and in the research side, you can try to see. Warning, in the alpha test that is currently running, we are not taking the content, but we are also analyzing the friend shared post. So if you want to use the current version, it's not for me. If you want to use the current version, be aware, in 1 month we're going to deploy a more privacy aware version. Interface, that is, we have two interfaces. The reality check is intended to make you understand what is missing from your daily information diet. And the reality meter is the one that, now we see. Link, Neuen, Fenester, no, new tab. This is new tab, I guess. But then, perfect, perfect. So, The Guardian wrote these pieces. Facebook and Google, most powerful and secretive empire we are ever known. So, low profile. Facebook is so much more than a media company. Facebook play both sides. It offers real estate, video advertising, and provides the assessment. That is an interesting point, because never happened that someone sell to you some good and tell you, yeah, yes, you're good, it went very well. Instead, with the reality meter, we can see how much the user, in fact, see a single post. And we can understand how a post gets spread in a user timeline. So here we have some anonymized user, in this case 7, that have interacted on this post. Less. Have interacted in this post for 1 day. When they saw in red is because the post was in a favorable position. When is low means that was low in the timeline. You can go a mouse over and see here. Well, sorry, I'm not exactly a data visualization expert. You can see here that at the position 13, this user that has access to this to Facebook only once saw the post in position 12. Other user got a different experience. So this one has a lot of access, has accessed 58 times, and saw the post at the position 7 only one time. Why all the other time the post was not displayed? We don't know. But at least we can start to critically judge that Facebook was hiding this post for that user many times, start to make this post in an unfavorable position for the user, and this can be one feature usable for who do social network research or social media marketing. We have some open API that can permit other person to design their own visualization, the time in which the user is active, or the absolute post list, so the post organized in chronological order, or the timelines of the user itself. This is the roadmap defined. Well, at the moment we are an unfunded small group of person, but we are here. We are communicating only in English and only for a person aware of the problem at the moment. We have a very small soft server and an alpha release with a small support. In 1 month, we're gonna do the first declination. What is it? The marketing idea is not to get a supporter because they care about algorithm. Like, nobody care about algorithm, eh? Nobody care about algorithm. The goal is understanding some hot topic in a specific nation and create a dedicated website asking to the user of that nation, hey, do you think that Facebook is promoting Donald Trump or Hillary Clinton? So the user can feel more human goods, a declined information, a declined answer to understand why the algorithm matter. And this is just a website that we want to spread the adoption of the tool just with a framing. In 1 month, the new extension will be released. That will just be crawl the public post. The public post are a good percentage of the post you are seeing in your feed. They can be enough to understand the trend or the virality of some topic. And that's it. So we need researchers and developers. It's an open source software in GitHub. Also the dataset is open, so other person can download it and do their own analysis. Grants and donation will be managed with the support of Center for the Cultivation of Technology. Just at the moment, we have no idea what we can ask and how. The current team is a very small, is composed by a very small group of person. Is Alberto here? He's in there, you see? The arrow is exactly pointing to him, boom. After, if you're interested in supporting the project, talk with him, please, because he's the new technical chief in charge of bringing the project on the beta. Our advisors are probably on the streaming. Thank you, well done. They mostly contain our hacker activist soul in a more professional and strategic direction. And Kiki is helping us for the visualization, usability, and UX. That's it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Any questions to Claudio? Remarks? Okay, but no spontaneous feedback. This one.
It's an awesome project. I'm really interested. And Connect is where? Facebook tracking exposed?
Yeah, this is the name and also the URL.
Okay.
Because exposed is an actual end of a domain name, like .com .exposed.
Okay. Cool. So you have a new supporter.
Okay.
Anne, as and another in there.
I think my question went in the same direction. First of all, great project. I really like this, and I hope this gets to the next level and to the other levels. And the same question, basically. So what do we need to do if we want to help this? We need to get the app from that website?
Ah, good question. What do you
and
can
and
do?
And what else do you want us to do?
Yes, perfect. If I have a wish list, and I have it, is person doing research and developers, this means person analyzing the open data and figured out what they mean, what is actively promoted. Promoting the extension is important in order to have more supporter and so more data to be studied. We need to move in a distributed storage and to do that having technical support, so sysadmin or big storage, able to host our data is another thing we can benefit of. So if you have some spare terabyte, we don't say no. Translation. So Kiki will help us to manage the localization in different language because personalization algorithm is a global phenomena. We need to communicate in all the language of the world, hopefully. And to do that, we need the translation system and the workflow that permit when the website is updated to notify all the translator to update their own translation setup. If someone has experience on it, please contact Alberto Alberto after, because we have also an English mailing list in which we want to host the contributors and the supporters. That's mostly, and clearly every time a new research show up, speak to your local politician and make clear that this is an actual problem, is something that has influence on the society, also if we believe that we can escape on it, or we believe that we are superior, or we can be outside of Facebook. Facebook has 1,700,000,000 of users. That means that will last for many years. The influence they have is invisible. This is just one way to make this impact visible. Improve the way to communicate this to the outside is, I guess, one of the important goals.
Okay, and we have one more question on this side.
I wonder, what does Facebook think about your project? And
me too.
Do you think can they change anything technically so your project?
Yes. Yes, yes.
And
we don't know yet which answer Facebook can have, but the best answer of Facebook can be that you user decide which algorithm manage your feed. You user receive a neutralized set of content, for example, chronological order of post, and then in your client, you decide if you today you want to explore, if today you want to dig in that direction, if today you want to see the world with the eyes of a Hindu person, up to you. If the intelligence come back to the user at the border of the network, that is an achievement. And that can be what Facebook can do if enough users start to understand why algorithms matter and why the self-determination of your profile matter even more.
Okay, but that's an interesting question. Anybody here working for Facebook?
Ah.
Who could answer that? Okay, surprisingly not. Okay, is there any question or remark left? All right. Then let's again say thank you, Claudio, for your awesome work.
Thank you to Berlin. Thank you to Berlin, Netzpolitik and Sibase for this awesome time I spent with you.
Well, come back to Berlin and have a good time in Rio then.
Yeah, but I will come back probably after the winter. That's it.